Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, my name is Jojo Palacio. If you're not new, thank you for coming back, tuning in again so we can do another tutorial. On today's tutorial, we are doing this guy right here. It is a cut crease moment. I don't know what I'm gonna call it yet, but I definitely smoked it out, winged it out with that liner situation and these lashes though. But let's talk about that skin. But let's talk about the whole tutorial. Like I absolutely loved it. I dug into an oldie, but a goodie, the Jaclyn Hill X Morphe palette, volume one, not two, volume one. I absolutely love that palette. It is so, so good. It is well loved on my channel. You guys will see how like beat up it is just because I go into it so often. Such a great quality. We did the full coverage. We did the glowy, radiant, summertime situation. I got some, I don't know, sunset-y, purple, orangey vibes. I saw this somewhere and I wanted to do my own variation of it. I cannot remember where it was because I cannot find it. Like I thought it was someone and then it wasn't. Have you ever had that happen to you? Comment down below and do that like puzzle face just so that I'm not the only one that does that, because I don't know, it was awkward. But anyways, I do a step-by-step walkthrough on this look right here. So if you guys want to see how I created this look, just keep on watching. Before we get into that though, subscribe to my channel. I'm gonna put a little icon there so you can subscribe to my channel. The subscribe button's also down there somewhere. You can find it, it's down there. And hit the notification bell so you guys are notified of when I upload. I changed the scheduling for my upload, so I added one extra day. It is Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday now. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday, you will see this pretty little face pop up once you hit that notification button with a new video for you guys. On this channel, we talk about all things beauty, and that is not gonna change. I am super excited to add another day. I just felt like we needed another day, you know? So anyways, let's get into this tutorial, guys. All right, guys, so let's get started. We're zoomed in and we are getting ready to do this look. So we're gonna start off by using this guy right here, which is the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette, the first one. And we are gonna open it up, and this is like one of the very first palettes, so I don't have the names, but we're gonna start with this guy right here, which is dead in the center. I 100% love that color. The saturation of the color is just so good. So we're gonna pick that color up on an M433 brush by Morphe. And like I always suggest, just make sure you get the brush super saturated in the color. Like you wanna just make sure all you see is shadow. Because what we're gonna do with this, we're gonna start with the darkest color first and we are going to work from there. I feel like whenever I wanna get a really pigmented look and just get a good saturation of color, meaning I want the color to just show up very boldly, you start with the darkest first and blend from there. So I just don't know what to do with myself because I don't want to be in you guys' way. Okay, perfect. So we're just gonna grab this, and I'm not swirling right now. No windshield wiper motions here yet. We are just dabbing this, patting it into place because I want to create the same shape that I have on the other side. So this is exactly what I do. And don't forget to show this outer corner down here some love. It's very important that you just let it know that you know. You know her, you see her, you feel her. And so once I make sure that majority of the product is already dispensed on the eyelid, and there's like, look at the difference between what we had it at first and what it is now, I feel comfortable enough to just start blending things up. It'll be a little less work. So this is where we're at right now with this color, because we're gonna switch gears real quick. And we're gonna go into two different colors, which are right above that one. It's these two guys right here. This palette is so well loved. Like I'm not even gonna act like I don't use it that much and just try to clean it off for you guys. I love this palette. It is so good. I love it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my Makeup Shack T59 brush, and now we're gonna really blow this color up. It's a much wider brush, which again just means that we are okay covering a larger amount of area. And I'm really just gonna go back and forth windshield wiper motions towards the brow, so that we can really bring those color forward and we can kind of make it like the other side. I always just want to make sure they're even. I know that you guys probably might not be doing your eyes like I do. I try to save some time on the videos by doing one off camera first. But you always just want to make sure that you are evening out the sides by doing things exactly the same way. So I typically just do it in the same order. If I lay down the dark, I'll stop and lay down the dark here, and then I'll blend, and then I'll blend. So you just wanna make sure that you can keep asymmetry. All right, so once we've got that color laid down, we're gonna go back to that first color and that first brush, which is the M433, one of my favorite Morphe brushes. If you guys are looking for a good, affordable brush brand to look into, definitely check out Morphe. I've owned most of these brushes for like years now. So I'm just gonna go back and reinforce the shape and just kind of blend things out a little bit. And what I always like to suggest as a tip is you guys keep a nice clean blending brush. This one's a drugstore one, it's by Soho. I bought it at Walgreens years ago, and I love to just keep it around so that I can blend and diffuse colors without adding more eyeshadow. All right guys, so once we get to this point, we're ready to start carving out that lid so we can get that beautiful transition that's going on there. And to do that, I'm gonna use my Makeup Shack T79 brush, and then I'm also gonna go back into a concealer. I've been loving using concealer as a primer, so I'll use it to carve out my lid. And what I like to do is just grab it with the actual brush. This brush is nice and big, I don't know if you guys can see it. I'm gonna let it zoom in. This brush is nice and big and it covers a lot of lid space, which I like. A lot of the times I just feel like I lose track of where I'm outlining if the brush is too small and I constantly have to keep going back into the eye. So that being said, I'm gonna start by just dabbing it right here, and I like to do it pretty high up into the inner corner, because then what I do is I look up and I kind of let it stamp where it would go, and I let it do its thing there. So I'll just follow that as my guide. Okay, so this we'll talk about because it always trips me up personally, is how far into the lid do you take the actual lid color? It depends on your eye shape, honestly. For me, I need to keep it pretty out, just because if I don't, it'll look really funky on me and it will look like I didn't really gradient or blend out that outer corner there. So I take it a third of the way into the eyelid when I'm carving out my crease, and then my crease, my lid. And then what I'll do is I will just make sure to smooth out that concealer on the lid shade to make sure that there is nothing layering or lumping. This brush just makes such an easy job out of this. I'm absolutely obsessed. So what I'll do is I will make sure to reinforce this color here next. So we're gonna go back into that first color, but definitely a smaller brush because I wanna keep it very, very specific to an area. So I'm gonna just put it right here. So we're gonna go into a different palette. This is Zoeva Screen Queen. I'm gonna take this color that's right here, which is the main lid color. I love the contrast of this purple and the oranges. It was like so good. So I'm gonna just pick that up on a Morphe JH41 brush. And this does have a lot of fallout, guys. So we're gonna use a spray to reduce the amount of fallout, one, and two, to really help the way that this color goes on, because it goes so pretty when it's a little damp. Look at that. Ooh. All right, guys, so this is where we are at right now. We're gonna continue to deepen up that outer corner to kind of get a gradient properly. And to do that, we're gonna go back in to the Jaclyn Hill Morphe Collection palette. And so we're gonna use these two colors right here, and we're just kinda gonna dabble between the two. It got the best depth for me. I was gonna try to keep it just that first shade, but I needed a little more judge. So that deeper orange brick type of red really did that for me. Boom. So now we see that it's definitely gradient into that shade. I just wanna make sure the blend is good, the shape is even, which is good. And so actually this side, for whatever reason, had way less fallout than the first. You guys should like see my tissue here. It is like covered with the purple, it's crazy. So just in case, I'm gonna pick it up on here. I use like a makeup wipe or maybe a baby wipe, that's what this is, so just do that. And let's get into the liner. So for the liner, I have a very specific way of doing my liner. It just works for me. So I start off by using a gel liner. This guy right here is the Maybelline Eye Studio. Whoa. Maybelline Eye Studio in Black is Black. So I'll go into that with try that again. I will go into that with a fine liner brush like this guy. So I'm gonna pick it up and start off that way. Okay, that I like. So we're gonna do a full coverage, of course, full coverage foundation for this look, and let's prep. So to prep, I'm gonna use this Smashbox Pore Minimizing Primer. I know that it's a little mattifying as well. I don't know how mattifying. It's been a while since I've used it. So let's just try this in the middle. I just wanna give you guys full disclosure. I was legitimately, seriously sweating doing the other wing, just so you guys know. It came out even, but girl. So for the outer part of the complexion, we're gonna use this guy here. I have been loving my Magic Lumi. I love this for a full coverage matte foundation specifically, and I like to use it in the high points. But then I don't know why I keep saying that. Like I literally put it everywhere, as you just saw, because number one, it just helps soften that matte foundation up a little bit, and it gives me best of both worlds. I'm actually gonna work that in with my Hank and Henry sponge, because I want the glow, but I don't want it to be super greasy feeling, oily. The sponge helps to absorb a little bit of that and work it into the skin better. Good old faithful Smashbox foundation is what we're going in with today. I'm gonna take that on the back of my hand with probably the Makeup Shack brush, I'm not sure yet. So we're gonna start off with that much. Probably overdid it, but I'm here for it. Here for some full coverage moments. That has to be my favorite full coverage foundation at the moment. So I'm gonna work that into my Makeup Shack T40 brush. Look at this side, flawless. Full coverage, love that. I should probably tell you what color I use. I use it in 2.18. I was editing myself the other day and I noticed it's a 2.81. I don't even think there's such a shade, and if there was, it's definitely not my shade. Okay, so next we are going to work in the concealer. Not concealer, I use a concealer, but it's the bronzing and contouring combo for today, or these guys right here. So I use the Milk Makeup Flex Foundation Stick in the shade Medium Tan to bronze up the face. Give myself a little bit of color back, you know? So we're gonna work that in first using the contour brush by the Makeup Shack. I'm just gonna start by doing the forehead first, and I just like to push it in. So we're gonna work that in, tap it into the skin first. And I like the smaller brush as well as my angled brush from BH Cosmetics, because it just really gives me, it's buff and it's tight, so it really just gives me control of where I'm pushing this product. Plus it keeps the coverage where it needs to be. We're gonna clean up a little bit later, but I just wanna push that stuff in right now. And then we're gonna go into our LA Girl concealer in, what is this, Beautiful Bronze? Yeah. So this is like a hint darker. And on the forehead, I just want this over the temples to really define, and then I'm really focusing this on the cheekbone. Not as much as the bronzing stick, because remember, contouring is just to hollow things out. We don't really need all that much. I just wanted color from the bronzing stick. Which, by the way, that is a foundation, really. It's not a bronzing stick like the Wet n Wild one is, or the one from Nude Sticks. But I just love the way that it works with my foundations, and I love the way it blends out. So check that out if you're someone who has, I would say, normal, older combination skin. That is such a good foundation, like a stick foundation. So, so good. All right, so once we've already blended that out and buffed that in, kind of like pushed it in with the brush, I'm gonna take my Hank & Henry, the larger sponge, and I'm gonna just use that to really push the products in. There is no additional product on this sponge, guys. It's clean. But I just really like to make sure I'm pushing everything together to make it look as natural as possible. The next step is to use our concealer. And for concealer today, I'm using this guy. I think this is like maybe the second time that I use a Huda Beauty concealer on my channel. I actually love this concealer for when I'm at Sephora doing makeovers. It is my go-to concealer. It is such a good concealer. It's full coverage. You need very little. I mean, it is so, so good. I don't know why I don't use it personally, but at work, girl, I love it. So I finally have some. I'm gonna take, what is this? 10N coconut flakes on a brush. And I'm gonna apply that starting in the center of the face, working it up the bridge of the nose and then down. Such a good full coverage concealer, people. Whatever's left over, I'm just gonna put a little bit here in the forehead because this is just a conceal. Like, I consider this a concealing shade. It's not that bright. I'm gonna go in with something a little brighter to highlight. So I'm gonna take my Hank and Henry smaller sponge and we are going to push that into the forehead first. I like to work that in to the bronzer and the contour, so I just push that, push that, push that. So I'm just gonna push that into this area here. It's very important that you blend and diffuse the cheekbone, contour, and highlight together. That is like the biggest thing I cannot stand. Like, you do need to blend things out, people. Blend. So I'm just gonna take a little bit more of that concealer. Actually, no, I think I want a little brighter. So I'm gonna go in with the Benefit concealer right here. And your girl's gonna just push a little more here. I'm gonna use that right there. And then maybe just a tad bit in the center. Just in those areas. Yes. Okay. I can deal with that. I can deal with that. All right, so let's go into setting that stuff. We're gonna use a Maxi 2 Studio Fix Powder and a tapered brush. This one is by Morphe. It's the JH07. So we're gonna take that and we are going to just press it onto our under eye area first. It keeps the color integrity, but this is really gonna mattify and set the under eye area. Lately, that's all that I've been setting. Just because I feel like my skin could not handle too much powder everywhere else. So we are doing it just here. I guess I should say that like my skincare routine has been successful. Cause I was trying to reduce the oil and I changed a few things that I did in my skincare routine and that worked. So now I was so used to setting everything extra, extra, extra powder because I was so oily that now that the oils have stopped, I need to like retrain my brain, you know? Not a bad thing, not complaining. So we've set that. I'm really just gonna use that much powder, like that's it. Let's go into finishing the under eye area. And so we're gonna go back into that Jaclyn Hill palette. And typically what I do, guys, it's nothing complicated to the under eye area. I will take a smaller blending brush like this guy here, which is the Luxie 231 brush. And I am going to dab into literally all of the colors that I use on the top. However, what I'm gonna do is literally repeat the same process. So I'm gonna get a buffing brush first and start off with that first color. So you remember how we laid it down and we blend it out from there? That's what I'm gonna do with this guy right here. So I'm gonna use a stiff brush, a smudger brush, and that first color. And we are just going to build that up right under there. Okay, so just like that, we're building up, and then now we're gonna blend with this guy using the same colors. Boom. All right, guys, so I pretty much leave it like that. We're gonna put on some Benefit Roller Lash Mascara, but for that lower lash line, I like to go into my BH Cosmetics Power Pencils in beige, and I'm gonna just use that in the waterline down here. Here we are. So we did that, we survived that. Let's do some inner corner highlight, and I'm gonna take the very, take this guy right here in this palette. The very top corner, I'm gonna put that in. It's like a very bright highlight. I hope we like this. We counted how many different compacts I picked up. Like, this is the third, right? Second, third. Ooh, we love that. We love that. And I have not added anything to that. I'm gonna leave it just like that. That is the Benefit Cakeless, the Booing number 2 concealer. I just love how it leaves one that, because I don't have to add any type of highlight to the inner, to the brow line, but it leaves it so pretty. Okay, so you guys see the skin situation that we have going on? I like that. I like that. We're just gonna do a little bit more setting of the contouring and the bronzing with this guy right here. This is the Kat Von D, the KVD shade and light palette, and I'm just gonna take that first one, which is called Subconscious, and my Real Techniques contouring brush, and we're gonna go into the hollow area here just to define that a little bit. And then what I'm gonna do is just use that center shade, which I absolutely love, which is called Shadow Play, as a bronzer. We are almost done. Let's get some highlighting going on this situation here. We're gonna use this guy, which is the BH Cosmetics Blushing in Bali. Love, absolutely love. And I'm going to take this guy right here as my highlighter, which is called Glisten. It is such a pretty, like, iridescent, so bold. Love it. Look at that. Perfecto. I have been loving this as a blush topper situation, so I'm going to use it. It's this guy right here on this side. It is Mimosa Sunrise by Fenty Beauty, and I'm going to take that on a Luxie 514 brush. And it gives the slightest color, but I love just the glow that it provides my cheeks. I'm not really about that color right now, but it's definitely about the glow. And look at that. Look at how pretty. Might need a little bit of color, so we'll take coral, just a little bit from that Blushing in Bali, and we'll just put it right over it. Okay, yeah. All right, guys, so this is the finished look right here, and I paired it with the NARS Honolulu lipstick. I used the LA Girl, what is this called, blushing lip liner, and then I wanted to kind of nude it down a little bit so it wasn't so pinky, so I topped it off with the Wet n Wild Liquid Catsuit lipstick in Caught You Bare Naked. It's like a glossy finish type of liquid lipstick. This is the finished look. Look at these eyes. Boom. Look at that skin. Ooh. Yes, honey. We did that today. So this is the finished look today, guys. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, thumbs up. Give me some comments down below how we like this eye technique, starting off with a darker color first and then blending. And then let me know if you guys like these, the Makeup Shack brushes. I think I've talked about it in a few tutorials now. So if you guys have tried them and you like it, give your girl comments down below. Give her some thumbs up. Maybe with a little brush emoji down there so I know what you guys are thinking. And that is it for today's tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Ooh, I changed the postings. So we are posting now Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday, not just Wednesday and Saturday. So hit the notification button, subscribe to my channel so that you're notified of when these videos go up, because we got more content now, guys. So I'm super excited for you guys to see it, and I will see you guys next time. Blessings, love you.